I did an ASMR skincare video. I'll link it down below. It was really, really fun. I'm so sorry if I'm frazzled right now. I've been drinking coffee because I went to the gym earlier, and then when I came back, I was like, I really want to do this because a lot of you guys have problem looking for a good sunscreen. Let me drink my coffee real quick. There's this one very popular photo of a truck driver, which this side is exposed more to the sun, and it's drier and more wrinkled, and also like a bunch of more spots. And this side, because he's less exposed when he's driving this way, it's like less. So that photo is sort of like a stark reminder of what the sun can do to our skin. How I try to remember is UVA rays are responsible for aging, UVA, and also pigmentation. And UVB rays are responsible for like your skin burning, UVB burning. So that's a fun way to sort of remember it. I cannot stress enough the importance of sunscreen. It's such a basic thing that we might overlook every day. So if you're using sunscreen already, great. I'm gonna recommend a couple lightweight hydrating ones just in a bit. You know, aging is totally normal. We all will age, but why not protect our skin while we age so we can age gracefully as well. If you have dark spots and breakouts that won't fade, the sun will actually make it even darker. You wanna be very, very diligent with that. Usually when we have acne prone skin, we're using AHA and BHAs to exfoliate your skin. We're using retinoids for the texture. We're using, you know, benzoyl peroxide to kill the bacteria. But all of those ingredients do sensitize the skin even more. So you want to make sure you're protecting your skin in the daytime. I test so many sunscreens, you won't even believe. It's like I test so much. Either they're overly fragrant, they're overly greasy, they don't like make me feel comfortable while I'm wearing it. One big thing is comfort, because a lot of people are deterred by oily and really greasy sunscreens, and I'm the same way. There are a lot of great formulations these days that are so smooth, they glide on the skin and they don't clog your pores and they don't feel like gross on your skin. If it doesn't break me out, I find that it's a good sunscreen. There are two kinds of sunscreens. Some people call it physical versus chemical, organic versus inorganic. Organic or chemical sunscreens, for example, are like avobenzone, oxybenzone, octane noxate, and sulizol. I'm not sure if those are available in the US just yet, but I know they're available overseas. I personally like inorganic sunscreens because I feel like they're less irritating to the skin. I know I have sensitivity towards avobenzone. Whenever I apply it, I feel like flushed and red. I think zinc oxide is actually something they use in diaper rash so that it calms inflammation. Not all of them are created equal. Some are finer than others, some are grittier. These are primarily inorganic sunscreens unless I specify otherwise. This one is the Essential Glow. It is a titanium and zinc oxide one. This one really, really is smooth. It doesn't leave a white cast, and all these are like essential oil free from Paul's Choice. They contain antioxidants. I feel like this one's a bit more nourishing. This one is the Calm Mineral Moisturizer, normal to dry. And I tend to go for SPF 30 because I have found that anything more than SPF 30 feels a little bit more greasier on the skin, and I don't mind reapplying, and I'll show you what product I use to reapply. So these two have antioxidants to sort of help combat oxidative stress and pollution, and both of these are very, very lightweight lotions, so I don't need a moisturizer just because it already does hydrate. They glide on super nice. This one gives more of a sheen, and this one's a little bit more like a normal satin finish. So if you have really, really dry skin, I would say go for the Calm Mineral Moisturizer. And if you have normal to oily, I would go for this one right here. Every time before I apply sunscreen in the daytime, I do use a vitamin C serum. I'm currently loving the Paul's Choice C15 Booster. This one comes with folic acid and vitamin E as well. So it's a really, really good serum. It's like a dupe for the SkinCeuticals one. And I've been loving this Revitalift by L'Oreal. It's a 10% vitamin C serum that visibly brightens up the skin. There's more like a liquid texture, like water. And this one is sort of like a paste type texture. So this one's a little bit more mattifying. One that's really good is this SkinCeuticals Physical UV Defense. This is also a physical sunscreen, they call it, inorganic. This one's SPF 30, and it's more like a fluid. So it's like a lightweight lotion. I find that this one is not as moisturizing. SkinCeuticals products are also essential oil and fragrance free. Yeah, I just don't think it's like nourishing enough for the skin. It's a very basic, good sunblock. Sunscreen that doesn't break me out. So I really like that. You know, the good thing about inorganic sunscreens is that it doesn't leave a white cast. So these products I'm showing you, initially when you apply it does look like a white cast just because titanium dioxide zinc oxide is also used as pigment. These are products that have a minimum cast. I know a lot of products have like a ghastly white cast, like e.l.f. Beauty Shield for my skin tone or medium skin tone, it might look nude, but for darker skin tone, it definitely comes off as ashy because my brother used it and it was ashy on him. I don't mind a little bit of essential oil, but I know a lot of people are sensitive to it and it might cause sensitivity to the sun. This one is the Madagascar Sun Cream from up here. You've heard me talk about this already. This is a physical sunscreen with Centella Azida extract. The reason why I like this is because I feel like even though it has a very low amount of essential oils, the Centella Asiatica extract works well with the vitamin C and it sort of calms my skin and it feels really, really lightweight and nice. One of the most lightweight sunscreens that I've ever used. For those who are sensitive to lavender, I think it's like lavender or some other essential oils, I would stay away from this one. I also tried out this COSRX Shield Fit All Green Comfort Sun. I'm on the fence about this one because I feel like the texture is a bit greasier, but it's not a terrible sunscreen because it is very affordable. It also has snail extract in it to help calm the skin, but other than that, I find that it's a very basic sunblock. I think I got some like small bumps because of it, but it's a very it's a bit heavier in terms of texture, only if you have really, really dry skin. I also have a couple that are super matte, but on days when I want to look matte, I really like this Super Goop 100% Mineral Matte Sunscreen. You have to shake it first because it tends to separate, and this one has a nude tint to it. Very similar to the ELF one, but I feel like this tint is a little bit more sheer and universal and like blendable. So this is also fragrance free. It's 70% zinc oxide. It's a very nice matte velvet texture. When it touches an area, it immediately mattifies the skin. So if you're looking for a matte sunscreen and if your oily skin want to control your oils and stuff, this is a really good matte sunscreen. Another one that's really great and matte, also needs to be shaken, I feel like, is the SkinCeuticals Physical Matte UV Defense. This one is SPF 50. These two are really, really nice because it blurs out the pores. This one is 1.5 fluid ounces and this is 1 fluid ounce. And this SPF 40, SPF 50, you can decide whichever is comfortable for you, but these two work pretty much very similar. It's very pore blurring. It's very velvet touch. Like, it's very smooth. It blurs the fine lines. It sort of diffracts the light, so your pores aren't as noticeable. So these two are good for that. One that's also pretty nice is this Kula Daydream Mineral Primer. This is the SPF 30. The texture feels more less like a paste, but more like, do you know the Mineral Veil Primer? It's sort of like, almost like liquid glass. Very, very smooth and velvety. It makes your skin look, feel like pearls. Almost. This is a really elegant formula. It's with a cap and a pump. Like, I don't really like screwing and opening like that. That's why I feel like I just gravitate towards things that are more convenient, especially sunscreen. If you're going out every day, you're traveling on the go, you don't want like to like twist this. And the worst is when like these kind of screw tops, like especially when it's this small, like it like starts rolling and you're looking for blind contact, it just keeps going off. My sunscreen stick? Sorry guys. This is the Derma Repair Sun Stick by Ayope and Ayope. This one does not have any fragrance as calamine extract. It's SPF 35. I really like this one because I can apply on like sun. Like even I have makeup on right now and I can just sort of apply over it and it doesn't really move that makeup too much. Obviously it's gonna move a little bit. It's, I mean, you're like dragging it. It's a really delicate formula. I feel like when you first start using it, you'll find that things are flaking off, but that's with all thick sunscreens. But as you keep going, like It's very, very smooth and easy to use. I really like this one for travel, to take it to go, and for reapplying throughout the day. I find that this has not broken me out. I honestly was a bit skeptical with the idea of using a stick on your face to go over and over, but I mean, every time I use a product, I feel like my face is sort of clean anyways, and if you're afraid of that, just wipe it off with a clean towelette every time you use it, and I think that should be fine. Another one that does not have a white cast that's really good is the Beach Shield. This one's a very light watery texture. It is by Crave Beauty. This one is a chemical sunscreen. It's Tinosorb S, I think, and it doesn't leave a white cast, so if you have deep, warmer to deeper skin tones, I would definitely recommend this one and this one right here. So for darker skin tones, I really like this CoverGirl Mattifying Skin Primer. It's 3% Ansulazole, and I tried it and it doesn't irritate my skin and it doesn't leave a white cast. So, and it's also like a really nice moisturizing texture, even though it says mattifying. So if you are a darker skin tone and you're looking for like a primer, so sunscreen, I really, really like this one. So that includes my review on all the sunscreen that I like. Yeah, I hope these help you in finding what you need. If you have any other suggestions for me and other types of videos that you would like to see, leave it down below and I will definitely get back to you. So I'll be also doing a giveaway since you guys made it to the end of the video. I'll be giving away all these makeup items. All you have to do to win this giveaway is be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and like this video. And also leave a comment down below to let me know you entered and what your favorite skincare product is. I hope you try these out and let me know, because I love hearing your feedback, especially on DMs. Like, you guys send me like, oh, this product works so well for me. It really makes me happy and makes me remember why I do this. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.